this show. But the item here tonight is the first stage in the process of developing the local plan and is therefore hugely important to all of us in this room and outside it. To remind members, Cabinet resolved to prepare a new local plan in February 2014, and this was followed up by a statement of community involvement passed by the full council in November. And we went into more detail on how we would consult in a Cabinet paper in December. This is the next stage in this process. There are two documents that this paper proposes to put out to consultation. The first is the Issues and Options Stage 1 paper that takes a broad brush look at the issues around Thurrock's regeneration. It asks the big questions that we need to have answered about Thurrock's future. What do we want the borough to look like in 30 years' time? What are local areas missing? How can development unlock this potential? How can development proceed in a way that is sensitive to the concerns of the existing community? And all these are vitally important questions that we want the community to answer for us. The second is the draft design strategy, which sets out our aspirations for quality design here in the borough. There has of late been some very high quality design in the borough. The new Seabrook Rise development is a visibly striking addition to the Grays landscape, and Gloria Anderson Jazz school site proposals were notable award winners. But we can all have identified historic developments in the borough that fall short of our expectations. This design strategy will put in place the guidelines and criteria that our planning officers and planning committee members need to improve the quality of our residential, commercial and industrial developments. We're not deciding anything here tonight. The recommendation is that we launch a consultation into these two papers lasting for 6 weeks, in which time we will start the extensive public involvement process. I personally think this will be one of the most thoroughgoing and inclusive consultations that I've seen in my almost 4 years in the council, with drop-in roadshows, resident and business panels to consider in more detail the aspects that we bring forward. I think this is a very important document for future borough, and I look forward very much to seeing the conclusion should it be passed tonight, and I'm happy to take any questions.
I think it's the most important. I think this is the document that every person in Thurrock who lives and works here needs to read, digest and contribute to. My observations are, as the Prime Minister, I've talked about this, the Prime Minister's questions today, hit the nail on the head for me quite acutely actually. One in the sense that if you have a sound local plan with, you know, contributions from local communities and neighbourhood plans, etc., when developers come along and seek to develop in our wards, in areas which aren't previously identified as specific sites, it would be so much easier to say no, thanks, but no. Whereas if it is identified, again, we've all agreed it, the community have all agreed it, the developer wants to build there, brilliant, make it happen. Come back to Councillor John Kent's point, yeah, let's make ourselves as open to business as possible. So my complete support, my only ask is please, let's get out there, let's engage with everybody. I know it's easy rhetoric to say, we've got opportunities with forums, with delegates from planning teams or the strategic planning teams, Richard could perhaps make a point of attending there if they can, just to really get this out there. I don't think I've probably made it quite clear how strong I feel about this, but if we could do that, that'd be great. Thank you.
Thank you. Councillor Singleton.
Thank you, Councillor Strayton. You probably realise what I'm going to say, going back to my rural community, I do wonder how you're going to, and if you can assure me how you're going to engage with them, because if you cast your mind back to the last time we had a call strategy, it had to be added on another couple of weeks, simply because Hornden hadn't heard about it or whatever. So I'm just wondering how you're looking to engage with Hornden. Not, you know, it's only a small community, but still it's surrounded by green belt, which is very important to us. And so I'd like to know how you're specifically, you know, we've got no library bus, we haven't got a shop anymore, how you're going to engage with them. Thank you.
Councillor Chitaga.
Thank you, Madam Deputy Mayor, and indeed, yes, I too welcome this report and indeed all the work which the portfolio holder has put into it. We in the planning committee have had many, many debates about the greyer areas of the council's development plan, and indeed this is quite crucial to set that in. I know many times we've had issues about this party supported it, but that party didn't, and all that stuff in the planning committee. But this is a good opportunity for everyone, all the 49 members, and indeed everyone across the borough to contribute and decide, or at least put their opinion in about how they want to go forward, especially when it comes to areas about sticky areas about green belts and things like that. While I've got the floor, Madam Deputy Mayor, may I also say at this time last month we were congratulating or wishing farewell to one senior officer. Can I use this opportunity to wish David Bull also very well, very very well deserved retirement. I think this is his last full council, unless you want to come back, of course, any other time, just to witness what's going on and the debate, you know, about clouds, silver lining, you know, things like that. But I wish you all the best, and I know that you and your team have done a lot of work going into this. Thank you, Madam Deputy Mayor.
Thank you, Madam Deputy Mayor. I'll echo Councillor Otis-Homer's words. Valued, obviously, sorry to see you go. These, you know, time happens. I know you'll enjoy it. I hope that you'll be the 160,000th of one person that hangs on her every word every last Wednesday of the month. Obviously, tuning in to making sure that we're governing Thurrock correctly. Councillor Spake said, doing this after the budget feels like the chat sweeping up after the end of the Lord Mayor show. I can assure you, as the officer that used to follow the guy that used to sweep up after the Lord Mayor show, it is very, very important what you've got here, and you really shouldn't have done yourself down so much on something that's so important. Consultation is actually something over the past few years this council is actually getting right. Indeed, we heard earlier Councillor Kent mention the fact that our fraud team now teaches government department on fraud. I think we've got another government department that can take a big leap out of our book when it comes to consultation. Cough, Highways England, cough. Looking back to the matter at hand, issues and options, from someone who spent a year and a half in possibly one of the most poorly designed properties in Thurrock from the late 80s and early 90s, if we don't get this right, I'll be sitting there wondering, is there somebody else in a flat, a one-bedroom flat, with nowhere to dry their clothes in the winter, relying on high-cost electricity just to get their clothes dry? Or do I take the risk of increasing my chance of black mould and all the negative problems that will give that person for the rest of their life? I don't want to be that person, and no one in Thurrock should be that person. They should be looking at this, and they really should be chipping in what they feel. And they need to do it, and they need to do it soon. Obviously, Giffey has been here for many of the local development plan, all the different options and so on, and yeah, it can be a bit of a dry document, and it can be quite heavy and weighty. Indeed, when I moved from a very poorly designed one-bedroom property to the house I'm in at the moment, I found a box, half of which was consultation documents for the last time we started to do this. This is much better, it's much more compact, and should be commended, especially indeed some of the good pictures there, including Councillor Kent's house, which is a really good example of what happens when developers get it right. Councillor Hibbert, nail on the head. If we get this in place, we can say to those poor developers who just want to throw up their boxes left, right and centre, the sole purpose is to make money out of Thurrock and the people who live here, you can go somewhere else for that. We want high quality housing, we want high quality design, we want things for Thurrock. So I will be supporting this. Thank you, Madam Mayor.
Councillor.
The State Theatre is, so this is a building, and I have thought about it before, it's that, is it the main listing, and what is the current situation regarding introducing Friends of the State?
Thank you, Madam Deputy Mayor. Thanks very much, Councillor Spate. I think this is an excellent report, which is a very, very important subject. Councillor Little, you mentioned that to Councillor Spate, how do you get this out to people, and you should be doing this and you should be doing that. Now, because this is such an important document, I'll give you a little tip that I've done. Officers were very, very good, and they come out to forums. They will come out and explain it to the residents, because residents do sit down there and they have reservations about this type of thing, and they talk and they all have what's going on here? That's the ideal opportunity. That's what I've done, and I'd like to thank them. They come out and done a very good presentation. So I said, you're not that far away, Sue. You're out in, you know, try that. Thank you.
Members, we've coming close to 9:30. It's 9:16. Would you like to extend, move the motion to suspend Council Procedure Rule 11.1 to allow the meeting to continue beyond the 2.5 hour time limit?
How long? knows the structure of the agenda, but to declare my own interest in putting one of the motions on, but we have a very important motion that thousands of people will want to be interested in, particularly those people who will be getting on the trains tomorrow morning. And, you know, we're elected to represent them, so I would move that this meeting goes as long as it takes to get these motions properly debated so that people can know where this council stands on some very important issues.
Madam Mayor, I'll second that actually. I think Councillor Ackett has hit the nail on the head on this one. Very important motions, not just Councillor Akers, but of course Councillor James has spoken the amendment. Two very important member reports as well. So until we've completed all business.
Yes, Councillor Head, this does give us the opportunity to build much needed homes. Not only for people that can't afford housing, because we'll be able to get affordable housing like these developments, but the other thing we've ought to look to is to attract what we call high net worth families. In other words, we want to now have the captains of industry living in our borough. Instead of going off to Brentwood, Chelmsford, Worley, we like them living here and spending their money in this borough. So I'm pleased to see that this is going to offer a substantial mix of that. And of course, the one burning issue, I suppose, which is going to take up all of our time in the forthcoming weeks and months, is the Lower Thames Crossing. And can you just confirm to me, it's good that you have this timetable, but will we be able to move forward before the government decide whether there will be a crossing in Thurrock or they...
Right. I'll go in reverse order because I remember these ones better. I welcome Councillor Rice's comments on the paper. I think the high net worth kind of aspiration to have captains of industry, as they call it, has been a long held one in Thurrock. And I think, you know, what is pleasing about the local plan is that this doesn't just sit in a kind of planning context of, you know, we need to build houses that are like this. It sits within a wider regeneration context that says we need to have an economic growth strategy that provides those kind of high wage sort of jobs in the borough, but also that kind of we're underpinning that economic development in places like Grays that's providing more services for people who want to live in the borough. So it is all interlinked. On the Lower Thames Crossing, I think on these consultations, it will obviously come into play on some of the questions. I mean, there are 40 questions throughout the consultation document, and I don't expect everyone to answer all 40 like it's an exam, but some of them will pertain to the Lower Thames Crossing. It is going to be very, very difficult. The Lower Thames Crossing, should it come through Thurrock in any of the options, is going to be a massive change to the physical landscape of the borough and will have to be taken into account in the local plan. So work will be constrained by the timing that decision takes, as you rightly suggest. Councillor Hamilton on the State Cinema. I wasn't prepared to talk about the State Cinema, so I can't give you the latest update information. The latest I know is that, as many others know, that JUA has been taken on and looking to redevelop it and resolve the land issues that have to stand in Morrison. So there is progress being made, but I'll give you a full response in writing if that's okay. Then going back to Councillor Glasgow, I'm pleased to have that I've got the expert opinion of someone who has been after the Lord's Mayor's show and can after the Lord's Mayor's show and can recognise the importance of the document. I don't intend to do it down. I don't think it is something that can be done down. This is, you know, as anyone who's sat on the planning committee knows, people come to planning committees, they object to say, I don't like this development, I don't like the way it's done like this. The opportunity to change how that decision happens is now, and it is going to keep, there will be other opportunities in the coming years, but this is the time to shape those big decisions that will affect your life. Councillor Little, we're planning to do more outreach work than just kind of sticking it up on the website. There are going to be road shows, there are going to be depositive papers in the library and in the civic offices. I don't know specifically the dates of the roadshows, but I think it is incredibly important that we do touch rural communities. So if you're amenable, perhaps we can chat after the meeting to discuss the best way forward, because I know that one of the things of this consultation is, you know, I don't want to go down the old tried and tested methods of this is a consultation, so we'll do X, Y, and Z, and C turns up. I want us to push the boundaries of what we do, so I welcome your suggestions on the best way to do that for the rural communities you represent, and similarly for those others who represent rural communities, whichever members for North Stiffer as well, and other villages. That is probably the main point answered. I'm pleased that the Prime Minister agrees with me and what I've been on saying about the importance of a pound-led approach to local government, to local development, so that is good news. And I will finish by, there aren't really words to sort of communicate my appreciation for the work that David has done in the regeneration of planning department. I think I started out in 2012 and went straight into the planning committee, and I think the department now is a portfolio holder in that 4 years. It's the same time that David's been here, it's immeasurably improved. Our aspirations have risen immeasurably, our delivery has risen immeasurably, and in large part that is down to David's work, and he will be very sorely missed indeed. And on that moving tribute, I will move the recommendations for moving consultation.
I'll move this in agreement with the recommendation.